Every time I look at Bezalel, Klein Aura, I get inspired. Bezalel is such an anivus. It doesn't matter to him compliments. It doesn't matter to him rewards, certificates. Last week he got a Klein Aura. Choshele to Eden. And he learned the affair by Zion Levy, by Zukir Levy. And he came to me and said, Papa, Papa, take my Tehillim. What should I do with it? And that really Titus of Bezalel. He doesn't learn to show the outside world. He doesn't learn to get the reward. He doesn't learn to impress his Rebbe. He doesn't learn to impress his Chaveri. He learns because that's the right thing to do. And every time I see how he speaks to such an Edelkeit, such an Nibes, it's a personal inspiration that I can learn from. As Bezalel mentioned, our family has mixed feelings tonight. Obviously, a big simcha. On the other hand, we lost the Rosh HaMishpacha, we lost our dear Saba just over a year ago. 4 or 5 months ago, it was Nana Mitzvah from a grandchild. And there was someone there who came to speak. And he said the following story about my father. This is really what touches up my father-in-law. He said it was middle of Sukkot. And he had a question about his sukkah, it was kasher, not kasher. So he came, he knew that my father-in-law was learning between Mincha Ma'ariv in a shul somewhere. So he made an effort to come and to ask the shayla. So he came to my father-in-law and my father-in-law said to him, give me half an hour and come back, I'll give you the answer. And half an hour later, he came to the shul and he sees my father-in-law walking over from across the street. And my father-in-law runs up to him and says, this is the answer. I'm sorry I had to let you wait so long, but I had to walk home to look at the sefer to find the answer and walk back. That was half an hour walk. And this person felt very uncomfortable. He said, I'm sorry, I was matriarch of you. And my father-in-law said, you should not be sorry. I should have known the answer immediately. It's my fault. And this was my father-in-law. Anywhere where you could ask him. It didn't matter which kind of sofim there were in Manchester, but they were Hasidish, Ashkenazis, Sephardish, they would all come to him. He was walking in every part of Shulchan Aruch. And it was a schus for us that he wrote part of the Shtika Torah that Bezalel so beautifully said tonight. I would like to introduce the Choshev Adam Goda Ad Moed, the Rosh Goyle from Baba, of Shia Fira. And every time personally, I hear him speak when he comes to our Chayder, when he comes and I hear him speak by the occasions, I get the Israelus from the MS Kite, and from the Dvokam Yuitzim in the Lake. In the end of a Yaakov, it says, Vayetzu kol adav b'nei Yisrael milifnei Moshe. Why did it say, Vayetzu kol adav b'nei Yisrael milifnei Moshe? So I saw a beautiful pshat brought down. You know, you can sometimes see people where they come from. Lahavdil, a person goes to the gym. When he comes out, you see, you know, he's sweating, he's walking. You look like he's been to a gym. When a person goes to a Beis Medrash, when a person goes to a shul, when a person goes to a minyan, when a person goes to Hevesh Shiur Torah, it should be that when the person walks out, you can see where he's been. The Torah says that when Bnei Yisrael, they were coming from Moshe Rabbeinu, Vayetzu kol adat Bnei Yisrael milifnei Moshe, they could see where they were, they could see that they came from Moshe Rabbeinu. And I saw this very stupid past about Israel and Shkoila. You can see in the city which Talmidim learn where. You can see which Cheder Talmidim learn. You can see a rain kite, a Erlach kite. A certain Tahad, a certain Kedushin comes out of Talmidim. That Baroshon, the Rosh Koyla stands and puts his koyches into it. It's a very great covet to ask Rav Shifir to say a few words. Lechavad Mamit.
Boit, Kusher Rabuna, Rav Tzudik, Shlita, Rav Mishpachton, here in Samaya, in the Tail Lechting of the Tzalan, the Kuvit, it's Kabulas all Toyle and Mitzvahs. It's very clear to us that the Tzalan, even though he became a Mitzvah just now, it seems like his Kabbalah's Al-Toyla Mitzvahs was many days before, maybe not years before. In every aspect, Yiras Hashem, that we've seen on his face, Zahab's Toyla, and all that is not a Kiddush. Obviously, his name says so much, it's Allah. I want to build the best Amikdash. And we find that the best Amikdash, the Mishkan, Hashem says to Moshe Rabbeinu, "Ra'ai ra'asai betavnisam, betavnis ha'ashat l'moyle l'or." You should build the Mishkan. The same seer that you saw it, l'or, in Har Sinai, I'll show you. The Bavatilim brings that the word Erai is found in the Torah three times. One here at Mishkan. There's another Pusik in Tehillim. Erai Hunim Levanechu Shulaim Av Yisruah. And the third time, the eye of Pusik of Heaven, the eye, the dead of Oitz of Bi, and the Chayim, the dead of Oiman. And sometimes we try, as the Bavatil does, to connect these three Pesikim that have some kind of connection to each other. Possibly to the Fekum of the Simcha, and to explain from where the Tzalon comes. When Amelech in Tehillim in Shir HaShirim, if a Kodesh asks a question, "Al Chusida, Al Chutablitz, Etzavaroi," "Where should I pasture my sheep in the middle of the day when the sun is so strong?" And they can't be under the sun. Where shall I guide them? And obviously it means, it makes his soul is asking the question. We will be in Gulas between the Goyim, and we'll have to raise children. How and in what way will we be able to cope with the misyoinus that we have around with our neighbors, that the children should grow in the right way that we want them? And Yir HaKoyvish answers, "Im l'saylilach ha'yufu b'anushem tse'ilach ve'ikva yatsoim ve'iyaz gidi asayich v'mishkenos v'loim." If you don't know how to pasture, you should guide them on the path that has been brought from before, from your ancestors, and from your great-great ancestors, the Derech Ha'Uvas HaMesayim HaKdoshim that have guided a pathway for us. We should only have to follow it. Take these children and guide them on that path. They will not get lost. On the contrary, they will connect to that path to their forefathers, the Uvas HaKdoshim, to Avraham, to Yitzchak, to Yaakov, to all the Tzaddikim, to fear the Gedolim. Obviously, this is the biggest story that we have today. There's so much going around us, and all the stories that we have, and all the tefillahs that every father and mother puts in. The Rebbeinu Shel Olam should help my child to catch on to the right path, to Ha'as Toivim, to Yiras Shamayim. And the only way we have to be connected yourself to the soil that we have. And the stronger that we are connected and we show how important it is, how precious it is, that we don't want to touch even 1 minute out of the minhugim that we have, children catch on very much to that. And then he follows suit. Says them, the soil, the pusik. We're going to build a mishkan. And we are told, the Rebbeinu Shel Olam says, and that goes on to every father and mother. Ira'ayim ve'asayim v'tavnisa. You should follow ketav nezachat v'more v'hor. As I'll say, my ayim v'ezbi, shiramas. Our parents are called mountains.